And then it was over. With the archdemon dead, the darkspawn horde quickly crumbled. Most fled back into the deep roads. They would remain a threat in the years to come. But the blight had been ended before it had truly begun. Ferelden had been saved, and the entire kingdom rose up to joyously greet its queen. Grey Warden stood redeemed, and a new age had begun. But at what cost?
My friends, we are gathered to celebrate those responsible for our victory. Of those who stood against the Darkspawn siege of Denerim, there is one in particular who deserves commendation. The one who led the charge against the Archdemon and killed it remains with us still. An inspiration to all he saved that day. Ladies and gentlemen, may I formally present my betrothed, who shall soon be your king. Grey Warden, it is hard to imagine how you could have aided Ferelden Moore. I think it only appropriate that I return the favor. As a reward and as an engagement present, I offer you a boon of your choice. I suspect you'll have plenty of opportunity to do that as my consort, in whatever capacity you desire. Let it also be known that the Arling of Amaranthine, once the land of Arlhau, is now granted to the Grey Wardens. There they can rebuild, following the example of those who went before them. What are your plans? I assume that as Chancellor you'll be remaining here in Denerim. You are no doubt correct. Having you near at hand would be a great relief. There is a group of eager Ferelden citizens waiting outside to get a look at their hero. I suggest you make at least a brief appearance before they storm the gate. Just tell the guard at the door when you are ready.
So, we made it. I'm impressed, aren't you? The odds were completely against one of us actually getting to the Archdemon. But of course you would make it. I knew you would. I just don't understand how you're still alive. I guess Riordan was wrong? I had no idea. I suppose that makes sense. Speaking of Morrigan, do you know where she went? I'm told she vanished right after the battle. No goodbyes or anything. Very dramatic. I don't imagine she'd be easy to find if she didn't want to be. At any rate, I'm looking forward to meeting the rest of the Grey Wardens when they come. We'll need to rebuild, right? And if I don't get the chance some other time, thanks. For everything. I'll let you get to your adoring public. They want to see the hero of Ferelden, and who am I to keep them waiting?
Allow me to offer you my personal congratulations, Warden. I must admit that while I did not share my father's pessimism regarding the Grey Wardens, I had my doubts that such a small number of you could be victorious. Yet here you are. Normally I would call that bravado, but it seems your confidence is deserved. At any rate, I understand the preparations are underway for our wedding. It will only be a matter of weeks. Are you nervous? Good. I feel the same, I must confess. You are rather intimidating, after all. We will need to speak more of the role you wish to play. As the hero of Ferelden, there are many opportunities, but that can wait. For now, enjoy the celebration. We can speak further when the day is done.
So it survived after all. My impression that all creatures made of flesh were hopelessly squishy was, premature. It has made me revise my opinion of its kind, my kind. I am, or at least was, a dwarf. A creature of flesh. I have to keep reminding myself that. In fact, I think I may even try to become one again. Gwyn has offered to accompany me to Tevinter to speak with the mages there. The Circle of Minrathruz has the largest collection of arcane knowledge in Thedas. If it is possible to reverse this process, then the knowledge to do so will be there, or that is my hope. And if not, then I will keep looking. I have nothing if not time, yes? I intend to return eventually. Unless I finally decide to destroy all pigeons everywhere. That may take a while, but otherwise I will come back. If it happens to one day see a tiny little dwarf who appears very nervous of being squished, that will be me. Until then, I wish it well. It, you have been a fine friend.
When I heard that my little brother was not only a Grey Warden, but also leading Ferelden into battle, I was surprised, to put it mildly, Father. He would have been so proud of you. I know I am. You've done good. Yes, I'm trying not to think too much about them. Hal was a greedy, traitorous bastard. I just wish I'd been there to help you kill him. At least Amaranthine now belongs to the Grey Wardens. There's some justice in that, I think. I need to go back to High Ever. See if I can clean up the mess Hal made of it. I will see you soon, I hope. My little brother, marrying the Queen. All I can think is what Mother would have said about that. Take care of yourself, you hear? Or I'll find you and nag you like Mother did until you're ready to tear out your hair.
So here we are. The conquering hero has won the day, and now he takes his bow and exits the stage. A fine ending. Aren't you getting married soon to a queen? There's a rumor. I suppose not. Once, I might have felt differently. But life is too short, you know? I can't help now but think of my vision. Whether it was the Maker sending me to you or whatever, it was a good thing. I thought I was supposed to save you, to show you the way. But it seems it was meant to be the other way around. Odd how that works, no? Flatterer. So, if I heard right, you'll be staying here in Denerim. As it so happens, my plan is to do exactly the same thing. Glad we worked that out then. At any rate, I should let you get back to your celebration before someone drags you away. I look forward to seeing you again afterwards.
The hero of Ferelden. My, my. How does it feel? I suppose it is at that. A blight defeated with the other nations barely becoming aware. Who could ask for better? Until you do something wrong. And then they will enjoy tearing you down just as rapidly. I'm glad not to be on the receiving end of all this attention myself. I say, let the young have their fame. Not that I've gone without notice. Irving asked me to take over as first enchanter, but I don't wish to go back. Not after all this. Instead, I've decided to travel. Shale has expressed a desire to go to Devinter to look into a way to regain her mortality. And I will join her. It's true, I don't know how much time I have. Maybe not very long at all. So, I shall see as much of the world as the Maker allows. Perhaps this is a gift in the end. A nudge in the right direction? I doubt we will meet again, young man. If not, please accept my best wishes.
I will be relieved when all this pomp and ceremony is done. Such events are perfect opportunities for assassins, after all. I can't help but expect the crows to appear at any moment. Which would be a welcome break, mind you. You see? This is why I like you. Always game for a little fun. You know, it does occur to me that staying in one place is only going to invite the crows to find me that much quicker. While fun, that might eventually get complicated. You said earlier that you are planning on remaining here. Is that true? That was the idea. See the world, meet some people, rob a few of them blind. Do you have something different in mind? Then let the crows bring it on. I can mock them while you crush their skulls. It's the sort of thing that made us friends, after all. Brings a tear to the eye, really. Well then, since I am sticking around, I suppose we'll have plenty of time to speak later, yes? So go on and get paraded about. It's fun to watch. Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on you and make sure no one gets a clear shot. Not without paying me a great deal of coin, anyhow.
Humans have a better taste for spirits than I thought. The ale up here is actually good. Orzammar ale tastes like dirt in comparison. Probably because they put dirt in it. Go figure. Yeah, for now. They may have already branded me a surfacer back home anyhow. I'm getting used to that big sky up there. And I'm thinking I might just look up Felsi again, see where that goes. Ha! I'll drink to that. Ah, well, enough babbling. That pot-bellied son of a whore Tegan said I'd pass out before drinking an entire barrel of pickle juice. I aim to prove him wrong. Who, me? It's been good traveling with you, Warden. Don't get lost in the shuffle now.
It is good to see you again, Kadan. These people, they call you hero. It is a strange word, but I think I understand its meaning. The Arishak on occasion has declared a Kunari to be Kunoran Vel, one who serves as an example to others. Such examples are always made after their death, however, a death in service to the Kun. A living Kunoran Vel would be too proud. When a Kunoran Vel is declared, certainly. It is one of few occasions when the Kunari are permitted to engage in revelry. There is imbibing of spirits, public chanting, meditations abandoned. It is madness. It is interesting. It can take days for the Ben Hasrath to restore order. There may even be executions. I suppose I should tell you. I have decided to return to my people. Your quest is done, and thus so is my reason for accompanying you. And I to you, strangely enough. It must be said. You found my sword and gave me a chance to restore my honor. I owe you a great debt. It has. That one of the Baz, a foreigner, would become known as Kadan to me. Unthinkable.
Yet here it is. Perhaps I shall see you again one day. Until then, may you always find the path you seek. Farewell, Kadan.
Are you ready, my lord? The crowds outside are getting restless. Right. I'll take you there now. Follow me.
Day and night, but dark.